Hi friends, welcome to Tech Guru. I am Deepak Jena. Today's topic is how to measure unknown impedance using microwave test bench and smith chart. The formula to calculate the unknown impedance is ZL minus Z0 divided by ZL plus Z0, where Z0 is the characteristic impedance of transmission line and ZL is the load impedance. In this experiment, we calculate the value of load impedance ZL. Load impedance consists of two values, resistance value and reactance value. We can represent it as ZL equals to R plus JX, where R represents resistance part and JX represents reactance part. The value of JX may be inductive or capacitive. If the load minima shifts towards load, then the reactance is capacitive. If the load minima shifts towards generator, then the reactance is inductive. To calculate load impedance, we should have the value of load VSWR, load minima, and two successive short minima, DS1 and DS2. After getting these things, we can calculate the value of lambda G and shift in minima. Lambda G equals to 2 into DS1 minus DS2. Put the value of DS1 and DS2 in the equation to get the value of lambda G. Now calculate the value of shift in minima. The formula is DL minus DS1 divided by lambda G. If the value of DS1 is greater than the value of DL, then the minima is shifted towards generator. If DS1 is less than DL, then minima is shifted towards load. For plotting graph in the smith chart, we need VSWR value, shift in minima and shifting direction. From smith chart, we get the value of R and JX. Let's start the experiment. This is the microwave test bench. We calculate unknown impedance using this test bench. Switch on the gun power supply and VSWR meter. Set the gun voltage at 9 volt. Set the pin bias at maximum. Adjust the modulating frequency in such a way that we get maximum power at VSWR meter. Now tune the micrometer connected with gun oscillator to get maximum output. Keep the variable attenuator at 25 mm, which means zero attenuation. Keep the slotted line at extreme right position. Adjust the tunable probe for coupling. Adjust the SS tuner for matching the impedance between transmission line and load. Select appropriate range in VSWR meter, which is in between 20 to 40 dB. Keep the meter selector knob at normal position. Keep the gain controller knob at mid position. Keep the input selector knob at 200K. Now our setup is ready. First, we measure the value of load VSWR and load minima. For that, keep the slotted line in extreme right position and move a little bit towards left. Observe the pointer of VSWR meter. If the power is decreasing, then it's okay. Go back to the previous position. Otherwise, adjust the slotted line and find out the maximum position. Now, coincide the pointer of VSWR meter with 1 in VSWR scale. Now move the slotted line to minimum power position and take the VSWR reading from the VSWR scale. Also take the position value of minima shown in the scale attached to its slotted line. There are two scales attached to slotted line. The longer one is main scale and the short one is vernier scale. In simple words, the value presents in the main scale is in centimeter and the value presents in vernier scale is in millimeter. This is the main scale and this is the vernier scale. For example, this is the position of minima. Now, first you have to check that the zero of vernier scale shows what value on the main scale. Here it is in between two values. In this case, check the marking on vernier scale, which is exactly coincide with main scale, and take the reading. To find out the position, add two values of main scale and vernier scale. Remember that the vernier scale reading is in mm. First convert it to cm, then add. Now we get the value of VSWR and load minima. Now we have to find two successive short minima to calculate the lambda g. Replace the mask terminator with shutting plate. Keep the slotted line in extreme right position and start moving slowly towards left until the minimum power point is achieved. At the minimum power point, take the value of position DS1 and continue moving towards left to get the next minimum position DS2. Now calculate the value of lambda g and shift in minima. Check whether the minima is shifted towards load or generator. Now we find out the value of R and Jx in Smith chart. By the help of VSWR, shift in minima and shifting direction. This is Smith chart. As you see, there is a straight line in the center of the circle. This straight line is VSWR scale. VSWR 1 is located at the center of the circle. Suppose your VSWR reading is 1.6. Now keep the pointed tip of the compass at the VSWR 1 and stretch the pencil tip up to VSWR 1.6 and draw a circle. Now check the shift in minima and direction. In the outer circle, you can see it is written that wavelength towards generator and wavelength towards load, followed by arrow mark. Here the arrow mark shows the direction to find the shift in minima value. Find out the value and draw a straight line from that point to the center of the circle. At one point, the straight line intersects the circle you draw previously. That point is common for one full circle and one half circle. Note the value of full circle as R and value of half circle as Jx. Now load impedance ZL equals to R plus Jx. To get more video, press the bell icon and subscribe my channel. Thank you.